Hi everyone, my name is Kendrick and welcome to Travel and Live Free. In this channel, we're going to cover the topic on how to save money on travel for Canadians, how to go on around the world adventure travel for Canadians, and how to use travel to get more freedom in your life as a Canadian. In this video specifically, we're going to cover how you could avoid paying a lot of taxes and fees when redeeming your Aeroplan miles. Now, I know how you feel. You've taken the time to save up all these Aeroplan miles, and then when you finally redeem it, you're getting charged so much money, like $700, $600, $800, $900. It almost as if you're paying for an actual plane ticket. So what's the point of saving up all these points only if you have to pay so much money on taxes and fees? The good news is there are ways for you to avoid paying a lot of fees. And it all depends on which of the Star Alliance partner that you redeem those Aeroplan miles with. So there's three categories. The first category is the Star Alliance partners that has no carrier or fuel surcharge fees. The second category is the Star Alliance partners that has low fuel surcharge or carrier fees. And then the third option is the Star Alliance partners with high carrier and fuel surcharge fees. And your goal obviously is to redeem your Aeroplan miles on the carriers with no or low fuel surcharge or carrier fees. So let's start with the first list, which is the Star Alliance partners with no carrier or fuel surcharge fees. And these carriers are Air China, Avianca Airlines, Brussels Airlines, Egypt Air, EVA Airways, Ethiopia Airlines, Scandinavian Airlines, Singapore Airlines, Swiss Airlines, Turkish Airlines, and United Airlines. The airlines with very low carrier fees are Polish Airlines, South African Airways, Thai Airways, Croatia Airlines, Copa Airlines, and Air New Zealand. And the airlines with very high carrier fees is Air Canada, Adria Airways, All Nippon Airlines, Asiana Airlines, Austrian Airlines, Lufthansa, and TAP Portugal. Now, there is obviously exception to the rule. So for example, if you fly out of Brazil, Australia, Hong Kong, or Japan, so starting from those countries specifically and flying out of those countries, the carrier fees and fuel surcharge is actually illegal. So in that case, they don't charge you a lot of fees. But if you're flying into those countries, you still have to pay a huge amount of carrier fees and fuel surcharge when redeeming on high carrier fee airlines. Another option, and I recommend you read my blog post on how to book an Aeroplan mini around the world itinerary, is that if you're booking one of those complex itineraries and the airline that's flying over the Pacific or Atlantic Ocean is not Air Canada, then you can technically stick a few Air Canadas in your itinerary and you won't get charged a huge amount of fees. So that's the only loophole that you can expect when redeeming your Aeroplan miles. I've done this for many years now and it's a great way to keep the taxes and fees low. So instead of paying over $500 or $600 on taxes and fees, you can look into paying under $100 or below $200. Anyways, that's about it for this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave your comments below. And don't forget to sign up to the Travel and Live Free newsletter, where you can get a 10-step cheat sheet on how to travel around the world, and also the latest tips and strategies on how to save money on travel, how to do adventure around the world travel as a Canadian, and how to use travel to get more freedom in your life as a Canadian. You can sign up to the newsletter in the description below. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.